Samsara and Nirvana never stir from their intrinsic spaciousness. Everything arises in the vast matrix of spontaneity, and spontaneity is the ground of everything. But empty in essence, never crystallizing. The ground is nothing, although it appears to be everything. Samsara and Nirvana arise as spontaneity in the threefold matrix, yet they can never stir from their intrinsic spaciousness, for such are the blissful fields of reality. The nature of mind is an unchanging sky-like supermatrix, a matrix of variable display, compassionate, magical emanation. Everything is ornamentation of spaciousness, and nothing else. It is the creativity of luminous mind, pulsating outward and inward, but nothing at all, yet appearing as everything whatsoever, and it paints magnificent, amazing, magical emanation. Outside and inside, and the material and spiritual dimensions, are ornaments of spaciousness arising as the wheel of sublime form. All sounds and speech and everything that vibrates are ornaments of spaciousness arising in essence as sublime vibration. All movement of thought and all inconceivable non-thought are ornaments of spaciousness arising as the wheel of sublime mind. The six kinds of mythical beings, moreover, with four types of birth, can never stray an iota from the spaciousness of their reality. And the six fields of dualistic sense perception of the universe, appearing in their own spaciousness like magical illusion, do not truly exist. Baseless, vividly apparent, yet empty in the now, supremely spacious, with natural clarity, they appear as decoration of their intrinsic spaciousness. No matter what the perception arising in this vast spaciousness, in its unremitting sameness, it is the Dharmakaya of luminous mind, disposed in the now, empty in itself, unchanging, unsublimating, as self-sprung awareness in the now, reality itself. Effortlessly, passively, it is part of the one blissful matrix. In its unchanging intrinsic clarity, it is Sambhogakaya, and however it manifests, it is spontaneity, uncontrived and unalloyed in its unremitting sameness. Whatever the shape of the distant, multifarious display, its reality is self-sprung emanation, magical projection, and it never strays from the non-action of the all-good. In the fail-safe luminous mind, the unfabricated Drakaya is already perfected. Not stirring from spaciousness, in its spontaneity, uncompromised, the activity of Buddha in Buddha fields is already perfected. The matrix of sublime spontaneity dawns in the now. Universal multiplicious diversity perfected in the now. This field of unalterable, unsublimating spontaneity in the now, this is the visible reality of intrinsic spaciousness. Non-crystallizing knowledge arising to ornament that spaciousness already arrived, nothing to do, without any practice, like the sun in the sky. That is an amazing, superb reality. here in this womb-like spaciousness, in the spontaneity of the now, samsara is all good, and while nirvana is also good, in this all-good matrix, in the now, neither samsara nor nirvana exist. Appearances are all good, and while emptiness is also all good, in this all-good matrix, in the now, neither appearance nor emptiness exist. Life is all good. And while good and bad feelings are also all good, in this all-good matrix, neither life nor feelings exist. Self and other are both all good. And while acceptance and rejection are also all good, in this all-good matrix, no self and no other, no affirmation or negation is possible. In delusion, we reify what is not truly existent and label it. Why is it that we so readily affix attributes to samsara and nirvana when their nature is so dreamlike, baseless, and evanescent? Everything is all good, magnificent spontaneity, and delusion, never having existed in the past, existing neither in the present nor the future, life is just a label, the paradox of being and non-being resolved. No one has ever been deluded anywhere in the past. No one is deluded now, and no one will ever be deluded in the future. That is alpha pure vision of past, present, and future. When delusion is non-existent, non-delusion cannot exist. And spontaneously in the now, pure presence is right here. Since there never was release, is no release now, and never will be, nirvana is a mere label, and no one has ever known liberation. There can be no release because no confinement can exist in the now. And pure like the sky, nothing can ever be restricted or localized. That is alpha pure vision of ultimate liberation. In short, in the spontaneity of this vast womb-like spaciousness, what seems to be samsara or nirvana is a display of creativity that at its very inception is neither samsara nor nirvana. Further, no matter what dream arises in the creativity of sleep, it is in truth an absence, a blissful rest in natural presence, smoothly spaced out in vast, unremitting sameness. Canto 1, Spaciousness by Longchenpa. From the book Spaciousness, the radical Dzogchen of the Vajra heart, translated by Keith Doman. Less is more right now. So that's it for this video.